I welcome you all for class 10, subject science. The topic is metals and non-metals. We are going to continue with our topic. Here we were learning about moderate, that is medium reactivity, low reactivity. Our next is high reactive metal. As I can say, that is you can see that is the potassium, sodium, calcium are very high reactive metals. How can these be removed? Metals of high reactivity can be reduced only by electrolysis of molten ore. What is the meaning of electrolysis? Electrolysis is nothing but passing of the current in the molten state of metal. Okay, the molten state means first daily metal, that is in a liquid form, the metal, whatever it is. Like for example, if I am taking sodium chloride in a container in a liquid form, then current is passed. What is passed? Current is passed in it, in that beaker. As you know, the current has two ions, that is positive and negative ion. Anode, that is positive, cathode, that is negative. Once the reaction is going on, that is NaCl. So what happens here is the Na, that what is that Na? Na is the metal what we want, that is the sodium. The sodium, once it is Na plus, it goes and attaches to the cathode there. Okay, cathode will be there. So it will go and attach to the cathode. The chlorine which is there, it will attaches to the anode, positive. You know, and that is opposite side, it will attract each other. The sodium, after the electrolysis of the molten ore, the pure, that is, it is 99.9% pure. Only one step is included in this high reactivity metal. That is the first, only one step, that is electrolysis of molten ore. It is costly, but to remove this highly reactive metal, it should be used. Now you can ask, why not the other methods? The other methods, there is no other way for this highly reactive metals. So only one method, electrolysis of molten ore, is used by passing of the current. Here we can get the pure metal directly. In the picture you can see that what is being happening, that is termite process for joining railway tracks. Here whatever joining railway tracks or track machines, how it is being done? By that melting of the amount of heat evolved is so large that metals are produced in a molten state. The reaction of iron oxide with aluminium is the method of termite reaction. Means it will be exothermic, very highly reactive, but they have to, once the railway tracks are cracked or machines are cracked, they use this method. This method is known as termite reaction. What is termite reaction? Means oxidizing the given metal. Means they will make it in a molten form and they will put it on the cracked parts of the machines. So that once it is in the normal condition, it will become hard. That is known as thermic reaction. As I said you, that is the electrolysis method. As here you can see, that is Na plus electron give rise to Na, and 2Cl minus give rise to Cl2 plus, and 2 electrons will be left out here. This is nothing but the electrolytic reduction. Here we are learning about the electrolytic refining. The most widely used method for refining impure metals. There what I said, only 90% it is pure. Okay, to obtain 100% pure metal, electro refining is taking place. What is this electro refining? Many metals such as copper, zinc, tin, nickel, etc. are refined electrolytically. Electrolytically means passing of the current. In this process, the impure metal is made the anode and a thin strip of pure metal is made as the cathode. For example, if I need copper to remove, I have to take the copper strip as a anode there. Okay, we have to use the same metal. Whatever we want to extract, we have to use the same strip, pure metal made as cathode. A solution of metal salt is used as electrolyte. same type of solution should be used. Now if I want copper, I should take copper strip there. I have to make copper sulfate solution, okay, in the tank. A solution of metal salt is used as an electrolyte. The apparatus is set up as shown now. You can see in the figure. On passing the current through the electrolyte, the pure metal from the anode dissolves in the electrolyte. An equivalent amount of pure metal from the electrolyte is deposited on the cathode. What they are saying is the copper, what we have, that is copper sulfate. So the sulfate will mixes in the solution. The remaining copper, it goes and attaches to the cathode here. The rod of the cathode, whatever it is here, it the remaining copper will come attach on this rod. Okay, on this rod the pure copper can be extracted. The remaining sulfate and all, it will be the other side in the solution. The pure copper will be on the rod of cathode. An equivalent amount of pure metal from the electrolyte is deposited on the cathode. The soluble impurities go into the solution, whereas the insoluble impurities settle down at the bottom of the anode and are known as anode mud. Okay, is it clear? Thank you.